Welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. We're back again with Flash in front of you. My name's Ali Baba, and in this tutorial, what we're actually going to do is we're going to get into using the pen tool. Now, if you've used some other Adobe products or even some other graphic programs, and pen tools are very simple, very similar. They're actually what I love about using these line tools and this drawing tool inside of Flash is that they're a bit different than using it in Photoshop. Photoshop, when you zoom in on a line, it has that pixelated edge. Using Flash and programs like Illustrator, really get that crystal clear lines, and you can really come out with some great animation by using them, okay? So let's get into the pen tool. Here it is, the pen tool. Shortcut is P on your keyboard, okay? And the pen tool works very similarly like most of them. You can click, 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 click. And as you hover over the end one, you'll notice the cursor has a circle, and that will allow you to close it. Okay, so that's one way of doing it. I'm going to grab my selection tool, select everything, hit delete on my keyboard. Next way of using it, grab the pen tool again, is click and drag basis. So I'm going to click and drag, and you'll notice that we have these handles now, okay, which now means I can come down here, click and drag, and it makes that curved line again with the handles. Click and drag, click and drag, click and drag, and again as you come over the last one, you'll notice it changed. The cursor has a circle next to it, that means you're closing it. Left click, drag, and that will close it off, okay? And there we go, we have some dysfunctional sort of circle happening, okay? So what the good about this is, you can come in now with the sub selection tool, which is the sub selection, which is the white arrow here, and this will allow you to select the actual points on this line, okay? So anytime you stop and then make a new area, each one will get a handle, okay? So with the sub selection selected, you can come in, you can move the whole image, or you can actually I can click on the line, okay, and I can actually select certain points just by hovering my mouse over the little square, left clicking and dragging. I can select certain points and move them around. This one here doesn't look like it actually closed, okay? So, and what you can also do is you can grab the handles. So you'll notice here it's got handles. I can make them out more, I can make them in more, okay? You can do that on each one of them just by simply left clicking on the corner, left clicking on the area, grabbing the handles, and this will allow you to actually move it, okay? Now, another good version that they got is that you can actually add anchor points and you can delete anchor points. Adding anchor points is pretty obvious what it does. You simply on the line with the add anchor point tool selected, left click, and that will add an anchor point. You can come in with your sub selection tool, and you can grab the handles, or you can actually move it and make the shape to be pretty much anything you want. The next one down is the delete anchor point, which is basically does what it says, and that's just left click on the actual square here, and that will delete that anchor point. And the shortcut to using this tool is, at the moment you'll notice we got the pen tool and we got the minus sign. If I was to hold down Alt or Option on my keyboard, you'll now notice that turns to the plus sign, which now means I can add an anchor point without having to come back up to the menu and changing it. When I let go of Alt and Option, you'll notice it turns back to the minus sign, so now I can come in and delete it. That does the opposite on the plus sign. On the add anchor point, you'll notice I've got a plus sign. As soon as I hold down Alt or Option on my keyboard, that turns it into a minus sign, okay? So that's the way of using adding anchor points, and then you would come in with your sub selection tool, move them around to make a shape that you want, animation, cartoon faces, whatever you want to do. Next one down in the list is convert anchor point. Now the way this works is, the convert, when you click on an actual point, let's say this one here, just left click, what it does is it turns it into an edged point, okay? It turns it into a strong edged point. The way to bring it back so you got the handles is, click on that same point, hold down your left mouse button and drag, and you'll now notice it turns back into these handles, where now you can come in and edit. So on the actual point, just left click once, turns it to a hard edged point, hold down your left mouse button, drag, brings back the actual handles. And there we go, you have this sort of, you can see what we're actually trying to do. And as always, in the properties area, with the actual stroke selected, you've got these options again of coming in here, making the line fatter, thinner, changing color, and doing all that stuff. What I want to do quickly is I want to just delete that line out. I want to grab myself the pen tool again, click, click. I'm just going to make some form of square, okay? And yep, that's fine. And what I wanted to show you was, if I'm going to zoom in here, so want to grab a point here. Let me just grab a point. Okay, you can actually see it here. Okay, I'm just going to grab this corner point here. You'll notice at the moment I talked about before about the actual join, and I said we'll go over it in another tutorial. Well, here we are. At the moment, this is set to bevel, which will give you that cut off edge point. Okay, if you changed it to round, you now notice it makes the edges round. And the last one you have is milter, which will actually make it more squared. Okay, so depending on the effect that you're looking for, is depending on how you want to actually make your edges appear in Flash. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this tutorial. Just wanted to show you these techniques, get you used to the pen tool. Pen tool is great, especially if you're going to be doing tracing. Let's say you got an image of a graphic, you want to bring it in a Flash, you want to trace over it with lines and stuff. This is a great way of doing it. Take it easy, guys and girls. We'll be back ASAP for the next tutorial on some more drawing tools. Any problems, please let me know. Subscribe to YouTube, check out my website, and I shall catch you guys and girls at the next One Stop Tutorials. Laters, everyone.